We would like to ask you to cease bothering our pest control specialists, as well as refrain from sending us any more of your highly inappropriate notes. All of our employees that visited your house reported absolutely no signs of a rodent infestation of any kind, and as such, decided not to act further than a prophylactic spray. Please treat this letter as a final warning, or else the next envelope you'll receive will be from our lawyers.
I didn't touch the workshop, just like you asked. Although, I can't imagine the mess that's inside. Also, if you care so much for that room, maybe you should pay more attention to where you leave the keys. I brought them back to your office.
I'm sorry for yesterday. You were right. I overreacted. It's just that this isn't about me. It's about her. Everything I do with her best interest in mind. I guess I've always believed that in an imperfect world, it's worth it to strive for perfection. Now I'm starting to sound like my father. I will work on my temper, though. Promise. We'll talk later.
Some call him the new Caravaggio, others compare him to Van Eyck, and one awestruck critic who wished to remain unnamed went as far as to invoke, quote, the spirit of the great Leonardo. Any way you slice it, the exhibition proved an immense success. Its distinct style has been praised for its unique combination of Renaissance influences and more progressive techniques. The artist himself attended the event in the company of his beautiful fiancée, looking stunning in her black gown. Revealed to us, exclusively, that the couple are indeed expecting.
Fuck up the links!
Figured you'd be up all night, so I made you a little treat. You know, I bet even Rembrandt occasionally took time off from being brilliant and snored his head off like the rest of us common folk. I know! In other words, get some sleep, you big dummy. sick and tired of us talking through these notes. We live in the same house, for God's sake. Come talk to me when you're done, before you go to sleep.
Might not be a household name yet, but just give her time. The incredibly talented multi-instrumentalist gave an astounding performance last night, winning over even the most ardent naysayers. Quote, "She was simply astounding. I haven't seen such passion, energy, and skill in years," stated famed pianist Daniel Richter. He was not alone in his praise. It seems even Anthony Giles, one of its harshest critics, has finally seen the light. Giles had previously made disparaging comments about the artist, stating, quote, "There's more to performing music than enthusiasm and a pretty face." When asked if, after witnessing last night's performance, he regrets these words, Mr. Giles gave us a look that can only be described as a mixture of awe and embarrassment. Pressed for an answer, he simply said, "Yes." The long-awaited opening of the Galactic Department Store turned into hell on Earth when the building's wiring burst into flames. While the majority of the visitors managed to reach the emergency exits in time, several unfortunate attendees were trapped in the back of the building, having no chance to escape the raging inferno. The exact number of casualties has not yet been determined, although it is estimated that at least a dozen people have been severely injured. The owner of the Galactic, Ronald Sheffield, has so far declined to comment on today's tragic events.
Sorry, couldn't sleep. The leg's been acting up again. Figured I might as well do some work.
Let me ask you one simple question. Have you completely lost your goddamn mind?
I know you're going through some rough times right now. I really do. That's why I've agreed to let you do those illustrations in the first place, for old time's sake. I even deliberately gave you a trivial task, because I expected Little Red Riding Hood to be something you can draw in your sleep. What I didn't expect is to get this demented nightmare fuel you submitted for a kid's bedtime story. There is no way in hell I'm using this, and I already regret agreeing to a payment in advance. Please, get your shit together.
Thank you. Hush. Daddy's here. How the hell did they fuck up the...
I didn't touch the work.
No, this is private.
Two souls, so passionate, so talented, and yet they wanted to build something so ordinary. A home, a wife, a family, peaceful life, betrayal of everything that made them both artists, and yet they clung to it.
We are truly thrilled to hear that you accepted our humble proposition. After discussing dates with my colleague, we find this date the best time to open the exhibition. We need time to set everything up. Getting a piano to our gallery will be no small feat.
What it takes to make a good painting. The work doesn't start with the brush, just like family doesn't start with marriage. It starts with canvas.
I can't remember the last time I wore these. The last time I could move freely.
Now, a tiny bit to the left. Yes, just like that. Hold that pose. I want to get all those lovely curves just right.